Welcome to Miami, where game one of the finals brought more of what we've already seen so often for this Miami Heat team during these 2011 playoffs. A swarming defense from LeBron James, Dwayne Wade, and the Heat. Defensive stops at crunch time to knock off the Mavericks in game one. And now it's time for Dallas and Dirk Nowitzki with that injured left middle finger, looking to bounce back like they've done all season long. And good evening, everyone. Welcome to game two of the 2011 NBA Finals, along with Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy. Mike Breen on hand, Doris Burke with us as well. Well, if you like offense, it wasn't pretty in game one. But if you're a defensive lover, boy, it was a thing of beauty what Miami did in game one. That defense now has the Dallas Mavericks trailing in a series for the first time in these playoffs. So, Jeff, the obvious question is, how do they counter?
Well, it always starts after making an adjustment with controlling what you can control. And Dallas can and must rebound the ball better. They were absolutely annihilated on the backboard. Their front court of Chandler and Nowitzki set absolutely no tone. They got no defensive rebounds from their guys off the bench who play on the perimeter. This is all about will. If you want to win and you're serious about winning, Dirk Nowitzki, Tyson Chandler, step up and rebound the ball in traffic.
It's a must-win for us too, man. And that's how we approach every game. We got less than 2 weeks of playing this game of basketball, man. If you're not exhausted after each and every one of these games, you ain't playing hard enough. If you're not exhausted tonight after playing this game, you didn't play hard enough, man. It's about playing Miami Heat basketball at the end of the day, man. Let's go, man. Here we go. Dominate on three. One, two, three. Dominate.
Game two set to begin. Our Spanish language version of tonight's game presented by ESPN Deportes. Use the SAP button on your television. As the Dallas Mavericks looking to head back to Texas with a split here in Miami. And they've got their hands full. The Miami Heat have won five straight playoff games now after the victory in game one and remain undefeated here at home during the playoffs. Nowitzki's first shot off the mark. James leading the charge.
And that's the rebound Chandler has to get. It's right in his hands. He's got to go up and attack and get the ball.
Wade, nice left hand. And the first points of the game. Well, the rebounding numbers is something that Dallas talked about quite often since game one, especially on the offensive boards. Rick Carlisle said, we lost the line of scrimmage. The old football analogy is Bibby picks up the turnover from Marion.
And I would be very surprised if the same exact thing happens in game two. I expect to see the Mavs respond on the board.
Bosh, that went in and out. They had a game, the Mavericks, against Oklahoma City where they were out-rebounded by 22 and still won the game as Nowitzki knocks down that shot. They've been out-rebounded every game in the Western Conference Finals and game one of the finals.
And sometimes when you get rewarded like that, even when you get pummeled on the board, sometimes it's hard to learn a lesson.
Well, they discussed it, and they were disgusted with it as they took each other to task during a film session as Bosh misses, and the Mavericks come the other way.
But you make a great point, because as a coach, losing the game gives you evidence that if you continue to do it, there's going to be a price to pay. You win that way, you think, oh, coach is just picking on us.
Well, game one, they only had 11 turnovers, two quick turnovers here to start game two.
And that first half court possession where they doubled James and then rotated, Nowitzki had a much stronger blockout presence than he did all of game one.
Meanwhile, we keep a close eye on Nowitzki and that splint on the left hand, injured the middle finger, a torn tendon in the final minutes of game one. Bosh gets the bounce that time. Nowitzki has said he'll be fine. Certainly the shooting motion has looked good in practice. Said other things, maybe dribbling, swatting the ball defensively. Nice pass inside to Chandler, blocked from behind by Wade, but a foul. And Chandler will shoot two.
Well, the finger injury on his left hand has nothing to do with his jump shot. And again, he's getting hit on his wrist as he releases, but that's just a thing of beauty.
All right, Mark, you're a player. You know this guy's got this finger. Do you go after it a little bit?
No question about it. And he wouldn't have to tell me in a press conference. Everybody understands where he's hurt. And if you're trying to win, it's not playing dirty, it's playing smart. Old school basketball says, I'm going to hit him on that finger.
All right, that's the old school. How about today's school?
It depends on who you're talking about. There's some guys that'll say, no, I just want to win. I'm gonna play the right way. That's not gonna get it done.
There's some guys in this league today who would help him ice it from their opponents.
Much more friendly a game. Many hugs before the opening tip. Unlike the good old days with stare downs. Sean Marion on James. Right to Bosch again, and Bosch struggling to start, just 1 of 4. He was 0 for 7 in the second half in game one after a strong first half. James on Nowitzki, and James with the steal. Saves it, but right to Nowitzki. Nowitzki pass, Marion puts it up and gets the bounce. They exchange some turnovers, and then Stevenson can't hold on as he goes crashing into the first row along the baseline. Good effort and hustle from Stevenson. Looks to be okay. Get out of my way. Nobody standing to pick up the charge. And everybody in the crowd seems to be okay.
Those are real fans. Those are Jeff Van Gundy type home court fans. Nobody looked to help or break his cushion or.
Absolutely. Come on, you can't help an opponent.
So they'll inbound. Some beverage spilled, but everything else appears to be okay. Bibby sets it up. Bibby struggled shooting the ball again. In fact, Mario Chalmers played almost double the amount of minutes as the backup point guard. Wade, spin move, shot short. Marion fouled by Joel Anthony.
Not enough credit has been given to Deshaun Stevenson and the job he does defending the best perimeter players early in games and get them out of their rhythm. That's outstanding defense against a tough, tough Dwayne Wade in a one-on-one situation.
He only played 14 minutes in game one, but that was early, as you said. Wade struggled in the beginning of that game. Jason Kidd using the screen. Marion, good open look. Stevenson from three. He knocked two down in game one, and a 7-0 run now by Dallas. Kidd, by the way, saying after game one, it's on me. He took the blame, said they didn't attack offensively. And Stevenson, he's shaken up, tried to fight through a screen. Looked like his arm went through awkwardly. And for his troubles, he gets his first personal.
They see him trying to fight through the screen, and good, solid, clean screen by LeBron James pretty much takes the win out of Deshaun Stevenson. To get back what Jason Kidd said is on him. I like the leadership and the accountability, but I think there should be a lot of guys dressed in blue that should think it's on them. A lot of guys didn't do their job in game one.
Wade puts it in, and as we mentioned before, they had a film session where, and they've done it a lot this year, they called each other out. Nowitzki called out, Chandler called out. This veteran team not afraid to police themselves. Rick Carlisle says it's been a big strength. Stevenson deflected by Wade. There's the extra effort in the rotation defensively for Miami. They've been holding opponents throughout these playoffs to 88 points per game. Eric Spoelstra talked about it from day one. As Jason Kidd hits a three-pointer. Dallas already up by 6. All 5 starters have scored. That's the way they like it. Good balanced attack led by Nowitzki.
And I like the energy and effort on both ends of the floor. You can tell they've come out much better prepared in game two.
And a foul on Stevenson. That's his second. He got caught in the post. Not a smart foul. Anthony really not going to do a lot of damage in there. So Rick Carlisle looks down his bench as he takes Stevenson out early.
Well, again, that's just good pass from Bosch, good roll by Anthony, and that is Stevenson's coverage. You can't be frustrated. He was a little late, but did a good job and pulling in.
Bibby. Mike Bibby. Boy, he's got to have a sigh of relief there. Bibby hit so many big shots in the playoffs with Sacramento, shooting just 25% from the field in these playoffs. Gives him a three there. Nowitzki. The double not coming as quick, but Nowitzki can't hit. Jeff, did he see anything different defensively against Miami than he saw in the previous series?
No, nothing, not anything scheme-wise that was different, but the quickness of the perimeter players, particularly Wade and James. Yeah, it's just an incredible difference.
Nice pass, and Chandler blocked from behind, but a foul call on the shot by Chandler. So LeBron James picks up his first great look from Nowitzki.
And we saw this a lot in game one where he didn't think. He caught the ball with the defense running at him and immediately looked to make a play. That time puts the ball on the floor and makes a play for Chandler, puts him in position to finish or get fouled. But that's what Dirk Nowitzki's got to do against this quicker defense. You got to look to attack as soon as you catch the basketball.
Chandler was one of the Mavericks very upset with his performance after game one, just the 4 rebounds in almost 34 minutes. Averages right around 10 rebounds a game during the regular season and playoffs.
And Mike, no second shots. 33 minutes, no second shots. Chris Bosh, on the other hand, 38 minutes, that's not even his greatest strength, had 5. Listen, Dallas is going to have to rebound like they haven't rebounded in a long time and do it the rest of the series to combat this star power.
Now, do they need all 5 guys, or do you have to worry with the fast break potential of Miami?
Well, defensively, they have to all 5 rebound. It's got to be a gang rebounding mentality. But on the offensive end, it's got to be Sean Marion and the centers.
Stojakovic has come in. Wade sidesteps. He makes that look so easy. And Dallas lead cut to 2. Wade already 3 for 4 from the field. Stevenson, season opening. He's been struggling with his shot for much of the playoffs, although, as we said, hit a couple of threes in game one. Already one here in game two. Wade looking to post up. Quick spin move, gets underneath. Up to James, flicks a 3. Miami up by 1. LeBron James in game one, 4 of 5 from downtown, and he forces Rick Carlisle to call a timeout.
Welcome back to Miami, where the Heat have an early advantage. Well, it's been an eventful couple of days for Dirk Nowitzki, obviously trying to find a way to protect that mallet finger. That's the technical term for that tendon being torn on the left middle finger. This is what he has come up with. This is essentially just a very small splint, almost negligible. This is the play on which that finger was injured. There was just under 4 minutes to play in the game. The finger bends. I can't even look at the video. He starts to fiddle around with it. In the next 48 hours, normal routine. This is him stretching. This is him coming in last night into American Airlines, as he always does with his shooting coach, Holger Gershwinder, trying to find a splint that would allow him some feel for the basketball. His pre-injury shot routine looks very much like the post-injury shot routine. Not much affected. He said, listen, I don't feel a ton of pain. I would describe it more as a bit of numbness. The biggest thing, guys, is he loves to drive left and finish left around the rim when he goes on those drives, Mike.
All right, Doris. Kid turns it over. He's always kept saying that once you get out there and the adrenaline flows, you don't really feel it. You don't think about it. After he hurt it in game one, he hit a couple of free throws, actually 4 for 4 from the line, as Gershwinder looks on here at the American Airlines Arena. Roe Blackman. Talk about good shooters.
Yeah, great shooter Roe Blackman was. But if I'm Rick Carlisle, I'm not taking Dirk Nowitzki out of the game this early. When you think about the margin of error for the Dallas Mavericks, you take him out as Wade and LeBron still on the floor with Chris Bosh. You need Dirk Nowitzki's presence on the offensive end, and you can run the offense through him. He doesn't have to score, but he's got to be a playmaker.
Bosh the drive and the finish.
Stojakovic just has no chance against Bosh.
And Stojakovic hasn't been hitting his shots, struggling especially from downtown. A 10-1 run now for the Heat. And a 3-point lead. Stevenson fires away. Not even close. Good contesting of the shot from Wade. And James traveled.
Bosh had a dream last night that he was guarded by Stojakovic. I mean, that's just too easy. There's no way Chandler can get across the lane to help when you just have a blow-by like that.
The bench huge in game one as Sean Marion misfires there. The Dallas bench only scored 17 points. They're low in the playoffs, 22 below what they normally score. Chandler, good defensive rebound there. And the Miami bench was excellent. They're a little healthier now. And they got big play from Mario Chalmers, Udonis Haslam, Mike Miller, and even Juwan Howard helped out, especially on the boards. Kid misses, Anthony the rebound.
And I like the adjustment by Miami. Joel Anthony was showing on those Jason Kidd pick and rolls, which allowed Chandler to get a roll once and a three on a hook pass. Didn't do it that time, just protected the rim.
Chandler breaks it up beautifully. He saw it coming, Marion the other way, and lays it in. That time, Tyson Chandler saw Bosch's little signal. He was sticking his tongue out, throw the alley-oop, and Chandler poking it away. Dallas in game one held Miami to 39% shooting from the field. You could say, hey, they played some good defense, but Rick Carlisle wasn't buying it as Bibby's left wide open and knocks down the three. And that's one of the reasons they had open threes that they missed. He hasn't missed two now.
Well, that's a breakdown defensively because Jason Kidd rotated. Somebody's got to rotate to his man. They did not, and they paid the price, leaving Mike Bibby all alone.
Stevenson answers back. Sean Stevenson with his second three-pointer. Well, he stays in the game with the two fouls and pays dividends, and Eric Spoelstra now wants to talk it over.
Do you think he went over that with the team? Look, when I want to spin out lob, I'm going to stick my tongue out right, then left, and then spin?
Absolutely.
I don't think so.
Not exactly a poker face. Haslam out to Wade. And Wade in and out. That one halfway down. Kid cross court, Jason Terry. Terry fires away. Miami could not hold on. Jason Terry, such an important part of this Dallas Maverick attack. Strong first half, but nothing in the second half in game one. He's been struggling shooting. Last five games, only about 32% from the field, especially in the fourth quarter, where he's one of the better players in the NBA in fourth quarter scoring.
If you're Rick Carlisle, you're not concerned about Jason Terry's ability to shoot the basketball. He can heat up as quick as anybody in the league.
Under three to play. Terry inside to Chandler. Chandler aggressive and gets the bounce. And that's what Rick Carlisle wants from Terry, Mark, that, all right, you got to be more than a scorer. He's had some good games where he's defended well, where he's dished well.
Well, coach will tell you he's their best pick and roll basketball player because he's such a threat coming off in pick and roll situations.
Wade, the crossover inside and scores. Maneuvering around the Dallas defense.
Tyson Chandler's either got to take a charge on that or block the shot.
Stojakovic perhaps got away with a walk. Crowd certainly thought so. Leans in. Terrible pass, although defense forcing it. And that's four turnovers for Dallas here in the opening period. Bibby will try again. Rushed it. James on the follow. Timeout Mavericks. Offensive rebounds huge in game one. That's a pretty impressive offensive board here in game two. The NBA Finals will resume on Sunday in Dallas, the 2-3-2 format. Sunday night, little earlier start, 8 Eastern tip-off. And game four and a game five if necessary, Tuesday and Thursday at the American Airlines Center in Dallas, Texas, and all the games on ABC. J.J. Barea in. Rick Carlisle going to his bench early. Marion to Terry. Nice fake from Terry. Knocked away. Excellent recovery. Miller. Nowitzki to pass. And Brendan Haywood gets it to go. Nowitzki with some nice passes early.
Really nice passes off the dribble. And sometimes, you know, on Miller's block shot as he lines up a three, you forget just how big Mike Miller is. So he can recover against Jason Terry and impact his shot.
Terry looking for Nowitzki. Miller called for a foul. Miller is 6'8 as he picks up his first.
Again, Nowitzki catches and goes, attacks. They rotate up. LeBron James does a good job finding Haywood. Haywood, good composure to finish the little jump hook.
And Nowitzki, catch and shoot. Well, the shooting not appearing to be a problem at all. 2 of 4 from the field. And the Mavericks back up by one.
That again, that's off of the movement of Jason Terry coming off screens. Creates such a problem against defense.
There's Chalmers in the game. Chalmers played very well off the bench the other night, as Haslam did as well. Back and forth first quarter now. 6 different lead changes already. Nice feed. Blocked by Anthony. Marion gets it. And Marion called, or LeBron James called for the foul as Marion went up for the shot. So that's 2 on LeBron James.
Mavericks doing a very good job of passing the ball on point. Brendan Haywood trying to finish at the rim. Outstanding block by Joel Anthony. Great job of not giving up anything easy. No contact there, but Sean Marion's pursuit of the basketball gets him to the foul line.
And you know, if I was an official, I would probably rush that call and anticipate a foul. I've always admired the referees that can watch the play and not anticipate. Great job of officiating, letting the play out.
If you were an official, I don't know what I'd do.
Oh, you know what? I'd harbor a grudge, I'll tell you that right now. Anybody got on me?
I love the friendly chats you have with the officials before these games now. Planting the seed, aren't you?
Give him a little point.
He knows what he's doing.
Shot clock down to 5. Marion on James, fires away, hits a 3. His second three-pointer, the Heat up by 2.
I'd smile, too, if I was the best player in the NBA.
Now in the playoffs, shooting about 41% from downtown. Barea, that's the shot that wouldn't fall the other night. Final seconds. James at the buzzer. Almost starting to expect that to go in as well.
Welcome back to American Airlines Arena with Rick Carlisle. Obviously a very active quarter for Dwayne and LeBron. In an ideal world, what would you take away?
Well, look, I mean, the penetration is a big problem because that leads to other problems. So we got to try to keep these guys in front of us. We know they're both capable of jumping up and hitting shots, but we got to make it tough on them.
You talked, Rick, about winning the line of scrimmage from that aspect through the first 12 minutes.
We're doing better. We're doing better. We had a couple of lapses. We're going to have to look at matchups, but our disposition is better so far.
Thank you, Coach. Mike.
Well, Doris made Rick laugh during the game. That's not easy to do. Meanwhile, a foul on the entry pass.
But it's interesting. 9 of the 21 shots by Miami have been threes. They haven't been to the free throw line. And that's where they lived the whole playoffs. And that has an impact on their defense because Dallas's best offense is with flow in transition.
James, meanwhile, only had 2 free throw attempts in game 1. Wade only 5, so combined 7. Very unusual for those two, yet they still win the game. Shot clock at 1. Knocks down the jumper.
Yeah, not much you can do there. That's great defense, but better offense. Awfully tough to defend LeBron James and Dwayne Wade when they're knocking down jumpers.
And J.J. Barea, who in game 1 really struggled, made some good moves, just couldn't finish. He was 1 for 8. He's come off the bench. Nice spark to tie the game.
He could put out his own DVD on how to run pick and roll. He's that good.
Bosch. Nowitzki on him. Bosch spinning, trying to draw a foul. Haywood. And then Haslam gets knocked down as the shot clock was down to 2. It's not going to be in the act of shooting. And it's going to go against Brendan Haywood. So Haywood picks up his first.
And you see Sean Marion connected to LeBron James. Understands where the help is coming from. In the right position. Sending him to the help. LeBron just patient, just patient. Creates the airspace by the ball fake, gets J.J. Barea out of position, and then the extension, the step back. That's a tough, tough shot. Nothing you can do in that situation.
Chalmers open for 3. Too strong. Barea the rebound. Now, that's not necessarily a good shot, but it went in.
No, it's a horrible shot. It's horrible possession. As, again, Dallas forces a long shot, doesn't put him on the free throw line and can score in transition. But you're right. That's not a good possession of offense. He's just that good where he just makes shots that really no one else in this game can consistently make.
Chalmers drives on Barea. Nice move, Mario Chalmers. who said he was so nervous before game one, his first finals, that he couldn't even take his pregame nap. But he performed admirably with 12 points and 3 three-pointers. Terry, and a foul. Dallas much more aggressive going to the basket. And the way they're going to the basket.
They're much more aggressive on both ends of the floor, defensively and offensively. Not settling on the perimeter, but I talked about it. They're able to get quality looks as long as they're patient and in attack mode offensively. And if you're Rick Carlisle, you've got to like what's going on both ends of the floor to start this game.
Terry able to put it in. You know, you talked about Terry and getting a shot going. He's always been a good shooter for his career, 45%. He's a very, very durable player as well. Over the years, has hardly missed a lot of time. You can count on him if you're a coach. You love that type. But they need him to snap out of this mini shooting slump that he's had.
And Rick Carlisle's matching minutes right now. Marion's with LeBron James. LeBron James goes out. He took Marion out. His normal rotation in the previous rounds is to get him off the floor early.
Nowitzki with the deflection. I believe with the right hand. Barea. Wade trying to go for the steal. Stevenson beats him to it.
Great play by Stevenson coming to meet the ball.
Nowitzki on a pull-up, knocks it down. Dirk Nowitzki with 6. And the Mavericks looking sharp. They're shooting 59% from the field. He's got a different role than he did in 2006 when they won the championship, and he was the finals MVP, averaging almost 35 a game. A lot more help. Speaking of that 2016, as Haslam has it knocked away, picked up by Terry. Terry going down the other end and lays it in. Of course, one of the members of that 2016 was Shaquille O'Neal, announcing his retirement as the great gentle giant. Calls it a career, and what a fabulous Hall of Fame career as Wade with a spectacular move there.
Sad day for the NBA, losing an all-time great, not just great center as Barea's foul, but great player and truly one of the all-time great ambassadors for the game of basketball, the coolest seven-footer that this world has ever seen.
Would have liked to seen the last couple of years. Obviously wasn't healthy this year. He so wanted to be a part of the Boston Celtics and their chance for a championship, which would have been his fifth. But he settles for 3, and they did a nice job here in Miami during the first quarter as Barea knocks down a free throw. A very nice video tribute thanking and congratulating Shaquille O'Neal, as everybody in the NBA did. David Stern put out a press release yesterday and called him just that. He was a true giant on and off the court.
Really a class act by the Miami Heat organization, because he didn't leave here on great terms, but a great way of acknowledging that they did win a championship with him and he succeeded his mission here in Miami.
3 championships with the Lakers and the one here with the Heat. Jason Terry spots up. That won't go. Deflected out of bounds by Haslam. Dallas is definitely, they're just much more attuned to the rebounding area, Jeff.
They are, and I like what Barea is doing. He's attacking, makes, misses. He's pushing it, attacking the paint. There he created a great shot for Jason Terry in transition.
The bench much more active than they were in a poor performance in game one. Nowitzki shot misses. Miller the rebound. Miller wearing that sleeve on the left shoulder that's been bothering him. Between the thumbs and the shoulder. Bosch, that's a tough fallaway shot. Too strong. Barea the rebound.
Haywood in game one did a good job on Bosch. His length and his size has impacted him.
Nowitzki takes his time, gets to his spot, misses that time, however. And Bosch to board. Nowitzki 3 of 7 from the field. Wade on the drive. Chalmers for 3. Again, they've taken 11 three-pointers of their 27 shots. Hit 4. A little sloppy hot potato. 7.5 remaining here in the second. Barea again gets in the paint, finds Terry, an open 3. Those are the shots they need him to hit. Desperate. Barea dives on Miller and a foul call. Those two getting involved. You rarely see, if a guy's on the floor, we say this all the time, you can pretty much sit on him. They're not going to call a foul.
And really a smart play by Barea. It wasn't dirty, realizing that it was Dwayne Wade was all by himself on the other end. So he's making sure that he can't pass the basketball. Take the foul, just don't give up the two.
And then a technical foul on Miller. Now that is a foul. And you see Miller reacting. Barea saying, come on. Helping out Joe Crawford with the technical call. So now Nowitzki will shoot the one shot technical. Nowitzki's on another streak. Last 100 free throws he's taken, he's hit 97 of them. In the playoffs, he's hit 25 in a row.
I'm telling you what, Dallas had a chance with three or four great looks in a row to expand their lead. Jason Terry's missed a couple good looks, so has Nowitzki. This should not be a 6-point game right now.
Meanwhile, the Mavericks, with that technical free throw, they've gone to the line 11 times. Miami still has not taken a free throw, and we played almost 17 minutes.
And if you told me that before the game, I would say, well, the Dallas Mavericks must have played a lot of zone. They're doing this without playing zone. They're playing solid man-to-man defense without committing fouls.
Right now there's a delay. Somebody spilled some beverage on the sideline. Well, we said it before, Dallas, you know, they're a different team. They're a team that's bounced back. They've got some mental toughness. They talk about game four in the opening series against Portland. The game they had a 23-point lead late in the third and lost. How'd they respond? They won seven in a row. They've done it all season long. They've bounced back. They've got a bunch of veterans who've seen every type of game, every type of streak. And so far, so good. Well, as Jeff said, perhaps they should be up more. Wade on the follow. That seemed to be maybe above the cylinder. That's what the Mavericks are claiming. Boy, he gets up. And it's back to a 4-point game.
You look at the separation between him and everybody else trying to get that rebound.
And Wade, nice class there from Wade after knocking down Pat Rondeau. Yammerman checks to make sure he's okay. Everybody loves Pat.
Take a look at this. Second shot opportunities. Dwayne Wade head over by the rim.
And that looked like basket interference, no question. But you got to hit him. You got to put a body on him. You cannot stand and watch on the defensive board.
Haywood. Very struggle possession there. First try to dribble it. Now Wade the other end and finishes. Wade electrifying the crowd, and it's back to a 2-point game. Timeout, Dallas.
It ain't gonna get it done. It's gotta be more, and you gotta do your job, and we have got to contain the ball. We gotta turn it up defensively. This ain't good enough.
40-year-old Eric Spoelstra in his third year as the head coach, 16th year with the Heat, second youngest coach in the NBA behind Monty Williams. He's only 40. He has done an amazing job, and especially you look at the pressure. As we've said right at the top of game one, championship or bust with this team. And he has stayed on such an unbelievable even keel through the highs and lows as Nowitzki's shot won't go, tipped in nicely by Chandler. And the players all talk about that, how his demeanor is supposed to be the same, whether they lost five in a row or when they went through that 21 of 22 wins.
It was very key to their success, especially during their early struggles when everybody else was panicking. He calmed the ship.
Wade, oh, difficult bang shot. There's just no defense for that. He's 8 of 10 from the field.
This guy is the second best player on his own team. It's unfair. How do you have two guys like this?
Nowitzki's pass deflected. Here comes the other one. Terry trying to reach in. And James will reset. Wade inside. Short-armed it, but he got fouled. And he'll go to the line, and that will be their first free throw attempts of the half. Not just him, the entire team.
You talk about how good this guy is. This is just playing around, messing around. Off balance, tough bank shot in the middle of traffic.
And of course, Wade is somebody that's been around Eric Spoelstra. When Wade first came, didn't have a great jump shot. But Spoelstra, who started off as the video coordinator of this team back in 95, worked with Wade so much really helped them improve. Those two have had an excellent bond. Spoelstra was a video coordinator, was the advanced scout, director of scouting, assistant coach, now head coach. He's been around the NBA his whole life. His dad, John, was an executive with Portland, with Denver, with the Nets. Growing up, he wanted to play for the Blazers when he was a kid.
Man, he went from T-shirts to Rico Suave. my goodness.
The crowd wanted a call there as Nowitzki with weight on him. Here comes James. Spotted up Stevenson for three. Knocks it down. A big shot there for Dallas. And Deshaun Stevenson, 9 points.
That's his job, defend and knock down open shots, and he certainly has done that this first half.
Mavericks back up by five. Kidd now defending James. Bosch with the look. Bosch just 2 of 8. Nowitzki with Bosch on him. And draws the foul. They don't seem to be sending the double team as early as they did the other night.
Well, they're really changing it. We saw the previous possession where they forced them into a turnover. That time, with him looking at the double team, they stay at home. But take a look here. The double team comes because he turns his back. LeBron James tries to run at him. Good job by Dirk Nowitzki picking up his dribble, recognizing it, and passing it on point to Deshaun Stevenson.
See, and I think he's made such an improvement. When he used to spin dribble from the perimeter, start one way, turn his back and spin, you could really time it up and cause him a lot of problems. Now he has a keener sense of when that double is about to be there. Seeing LeBron James right on target. And give Stevenson credit. This guy in both games has had a huge impact.
And Nowitzki's streak continues. Now 28 consecutive free throws made. This is the largest lead for Dallas, a 7-point advantage. They had an 8-point lead in game one. That was early in the third quarter. James on the drive, trying to draw a foul. Oh, and he knocks it in as well. Count it. And one. The strength after getting hit and putting up still a quality shot.
I mean, what are you supposed to do? I can't understand. What are you supposed to do against these two guys?
Lose. That's what you're, I mean, listen, the shots they're making threes, they're making these incredible shots.
But you look, they're hitting these incredible shots, which of course they did as well in game one. They're down five. Dallas has bounced back in a good, aggressive, physical way.
Well, and Mark said it, you know, all along. I'm a big proponent of the Heat's defense. I think it's a great defense. Mark thought after game one there were some holes that could be exploited, and they've done a great job, Dallas has, in moving the ball quicker and exploiting some opportunities.
By the way, the rebounding numbers, which was key for Carlisle, Dallas plus three. Kidd the fake, the drive, flips it into Chandler. Nice assist from Jason Kidd, and it's back to seven.
You want to make Jason Kidd a scorer when he puts the ball on the floor to drive. Don't help, force him to make the basket because he's looking to drop off passes.
I mean, what a difference from game two in a lot of ways. Wade throws it inside. Anthony to Haslam. Not that time. Marion the rebound.
And a great job by Tyson Chandler keeping Heat guys off of the boards. Uses his body and allows other guys to do the job.
Nowitzki sets up Kidd. Chandler trying to get the offensive rebound, and he's fouled. That's the 14th foul, so Dallas will get a new 24 with 3:22 remaining. And that's LeBron James' third personal foul.
You got to know a guy's body of work. Jason Kidd is a facilitator. He's looking to make passes. So in dribble penetration situations, force him to score the basketball. Give Tyson Chandler credit. On both ends of the floor, he is battling for possession when you talk about rebounds.
And that's why you can't always just look at the stat sheet, because at the other end on the defensive rebound, Tyson Chandler did all the work so that their team got the rebound.
Bad pass, Miller with the deflection. throws it ahead to Wade. Oh, what a perfect pass. But Wade can't finish. He's furious. And then buffed into Chandler. Marion finishes down the other end. Wade still yelling at Kenny Maurer. And Eric Spoelstra irate, too. He thought there should have been a foul call. Jason Kidd and the Dallas Mavericks up by 9 with under 3 to play. Second quarter of game 2 at 38. Just continues to play some great basketball.
Great vision. And Mark made the point. When he drives, he's driving to pass. Finds Chandler with a little left-hand drop-off. And here, the look away to Sean Marion to create another easy score for Dallas.
They were teasing him the other day. Dirk Nowitzki called him a fossil. Dwayne Wade said he remembers watching him on black and white TV. But he has been a tremendous player for a long time, Jason Kidd, and he's going to be in the Hall of Fame someday.
You know, antiques are sometimes better than the more modern version.
Foul away from the ball. You see Nowitzki doing a Kevin Garnett, knocking the shot away after the whistle. Make sure he don't get a good feel going it through. Seeing it go through. That foul is on Terry, his first, and they're in the penalty. I haven't made a free throw yet. They've only taken 3, but they're 0 for 3 as Chalmers goes to the line. Well, don't miss the tip-off of the WNBA's 15th season as the defending champion Seattle Storm play host to the Phoenix Mercury on Saturday, June 4th on ABC at 3 p.m. Eastern Time. WNBA, expect great. Speaking of the WNBA, Ronnie Rothstein, the assistant coach for Eric Spoelstra. He's once a head coach, WNBA, longtime NBA vet.
Of the defunct Miami Soul.
There's Ronnie Rothstein, Westchester County guy back in New York. Great basketball man.
And at that free throw, Joey Crawford sternly warned Eric Spoelstra, and he told all of his other officials to not listen anymore.
Foul on Chandler after he had the shot blocked. That's his second. They're in the penalty now, so the Heat will get to the line. Chandler and Haywood in the Dallas front line trying to make up for a poor rebounding game in game 1, especially on the offensive glass. Miami led 16-6 in game 1, but Dallas has done an excellent job responding. And there's Bosch, the Dallas native. Was not a Mavericks fan growing up. He said they were a bad team when he was a kid. Although he loves Tim Duncan, stone's throw away in San Antonio, was a big Kevin Garnett fan as well.
So Bosch is the type of guy, he only likes his hometown team if they're good?
Well, you're a typical kid back then. It's hard to root for a bad team when you're a kid. How about all the kids in the 90s from all over the country? They were just big Bulls fans.
Yeah, okay, but...
All right, who'd you root for when you were a kid?
Oakland Raiders, Daryl LaMonica. Are you kidding me?
Well, they were
great quarterbacks of all time.
It was easy to root for them.
Yeah, it was. They were good. Mark Van Egan.
We don't need you to go down the roster.
Terry, out the kid. The extra pass, one on the shot clock. They're not going to get it off in time and a 24-second violation. Well, great rotation defensively, although Dallas had some shots they should have taken.
No, but you were right. That's clinic type of defense right there. The multiple efforts, the reaction to the dribble penetration, and then finishing it with great closeouts.
Five-point Mavericks lead as we approach 2 minutes remaining. Wade, bad pass, and Terry called for the foul. That's a tough one. They're both going for an errant pass, and as Terry picks up his second. So Chalmers will go to the line. Chalmers trying to be one of those players that won an NCAA title and an NBA championship. 2008, when the NCAA title with Kansas, was the most outstanding player of the Final Four, hit that game-tying 3 against Memphis. From Anchorage, Alaska, his dad was his high school coach, won a couple of state titles. He's a good player, has done a good job off the bench. His career here, he's been a starter sometimes, coming off.
And had every right to be upset when they bring in Mike Bibby and Mike Bibby starts. But give him credit. Embraced the new role and has flourished in it.
Barea. Barea, the drive, pull up shot. Won't go. Miller comes crashing in, and Wade picks up the loose ball. Wade nearly falls, keeps his balance, out to Chalmers, a three. Nowitzki tips it out of bounds. It should be Miami ball. Yes, the new 24. Haslam and Nowitzki battling for the rebound. Those two battled back in 06, playing against each other in the finals. Nowitzki giving Haslam a lot of credit, said he's one of the best defenders at his position in the entire league. Wade, shot clock at 7, draws the foul on Marion. So good at that, as Marion picks up his second.
Oh, and this is a big last couple of minutes for the Dallas Mavericks. You can either win or lose this game. You have an opportunity to increase the lead, and what's taking place is that the Miami Heat are chopping away at the lead. So you get to the foul line, you have bad possessions, and you look up, and now you got to win the game all over again, as opposed to putting them away when you should have.
And LeBron James goes to the bench, and this is the greatness of this team. It's LeBron James goes to the bench. Bosch struggling. Wade takes over. Wade struggles at the end of the Chicago series. James and Bosch take over. I mean, this is it's a very tough nut to crack to beat this team because of their depth of star power.
Well, when LeBron James went to the bench, since then they've gone on a 6-0 run. All have come from the free throw line. They're finally getting there. Final minute, second quarter. Marion. The double team by Chalmers, pokes it away, still loose. Marion gets it back. Nowitzki puts up a three. Too strong. And Barea tips it, but right to Bosch. Chalmers says, let's slow it down. Wade fires. It's a three. Wade from downtown to tie the game. A 9-0 run.
This guy shot the basketball and started walking the other way. That's called being in a zone.
Nowitzki.
Terrible clock management. They should have taken the last shot.
Miller's hurt meanwhile. Wade looking. Wade puts it up. And that ends the first half. Oh, a strong finish. A 9-0 finish for the Miami Heat. Coming up, we'll have the T-Mobile halftime report. Stuart Scott, Magic Johnson, John Barry, Michael Wilbon. They'll analyze the first half. And a special one-on-one with 38-year-old Jason Kidd. As Dwayne Wade finishes with a flourish, 21 points, 9 of 13 from the field. He gets to talk with Doris.
Well, he and his team finished with a flourish, a 9-0 run for your group. How did you do that?
Well, we just play. You know, we stopped worrying about what we wasn't getting. We actually was aggressive, got to the line, got back in it. But our defense.
21 points for you. Why are you so active? What are you trying to achieve out there?
Well, just aggressive. You know, taking what the defense gave me. I'm understanding I got to mix it up. So just trying to take off what I did in the second half last game.
Thank you, Dwayne.
See how hard that skirmish was that last 4.5 minutes. It's going to take that. It's simply going to take that. That type of high motor, competitive, laying it all out there. It is going to take that here for 24 minutes, okay, to get this one.
So Wade with the 21 points. Mark, Dallas obviously didn't like the way it finished, but what did you like from them overall in that first half?
I thought once again they got good looks, especially Dirk Nowitzki. One or two times it was good defense, but he just missed open shots. At some point he's got to be more aggressive, and he's got to pick up his offensive intensity because this team needs him to score and be a playmaker.
Bibby Starting here in the third, Bibby hit a couple of threes in that first half. Must have felt so good for them to go down for him. And a kick by Stevenson. Shot clock will be reset to 14. Meanwhile, Nowitzki just 3 of 10 from the field. Again, it doesn't look like that splint on his non-shooting hand has anything to do with that. Although it's easy for us to say, we're not the ones wearing a splint. Bosch drives, stripped, and Nowitzki, good job defensively.
I really don't think it has anything to do with his left hand. Where he's shooting the basketball, he's just missing shots. But I think he's got to find a way like he did in the Oklahoma City Thunder series. Get the basketball and make plays.
Shot clock down to 6 now. Kid trying to find Marion. He does, and Sean Marion can't get the flip shot. Chandler keeps it alive at a new 24. Bosch on Nowitzki. Takes it away. Bibby ahead to Wade. 2-on-1. James, the finish. All starting with Bosch's defense down the other end. Marion inside Chandler. He's fouled. Bosch with the reach in. That might be Bosch's third foul. So Bosch and James each with 3.
And this is a recipe for disaster. Great defense by Chris Bosch. You can't turn the basketball over because time and time again, when you do, there's a price to pay. Dwayne Wade, the on-point bounce pass, and then best finish in basketball. LeBron James at the rim.
Bosch not known for his defense when he was with Toronto, but he's come a long way. I mean, the entire team, it's such a defensive mentality. And I guess, Jeff, you give credit to 2 places. Obviously, Eric Spoelstra, day in and day out, that's what they talk about. But also, when you have your star players leading the charge defensively, it has to filter down.
Right. Bosch was on the last place defensive team the year before in Toronto. And when you're a star, you have to take that responsibility. You probably didn't value defense the way it should have been. But give him credit here, he's bought into, because of the better players and the great coaching they receive, the defense it takes to win big.
Bibby misses. Bosch, the rebound. Won't go. Nearly tipped in. The Heat in that first half, only 2 offensive rebounds. You have to remember, 16 in game 1. Nowitzki. Oh, he fouls Wade and he gets past him. That looked like a foul.
It looked like he was trying to, but Dwayne Wade just too slick. Rolled by Nowitzki and then finishes with a spectacular dunk.
Well, Slick's got 23. Bad pass.
It's the turnovers. This is what ignites Miami.
And the finish again. 3 costly turnovers leading to fast break buckets, and Dallas needs a timeout. Amazing how quickly it can change. The Heat with their largest lead of the night.
We've talked a lot about Miami and Haslam's injury and Miller's injury. We have not mentioned as much about Caron Butler's injury, season-ending injury, and Roddy Bobois' injury. Both guys were starters at one point for Dallas this year.
Butler averaged 15 a game, injured back in January, as Nowitzki misfires. James the rebound. James pushing. Back out Bibby. Open 3. Nearly tipped in by Wade. Nowitzki battling. Comes up with a rebound. We've seen a couple of highlight tip-ins from James and Wade in the first half. The Heat have picked up their defense here to start this third period. Four to shoot. Marion. That's what Marion been doing his whole career, 12 points. Marion, again, scoring much more the last several games. He was coming off the bench before Caron Butler got injured. That's when Dallas had that unbelievable start in the regular season.
Sean Marion has played exceptionally well since game 2 of the Western Conference Finals on both ends of the floor.
Inside pass to Bosch. Misses. And Nowitzki, another rebound. Dallas still with a slight edge in the rebounding. Nowitzki spinning against Anthony. takes his time and banks it in.
They need Dirk Nowitzki to play that way. We talked about in the previous series how he felt like he was the best player on the floor, like he played with an edge and he looked like it. He hasn't looked that way thus far in this series. They need him to take over on the offensive end.
Well, he had missed six consecutive shots before banking that one in. Just 4 of 12 from the field. And a whistle and a foul, or is it a kickball? Kickball.
Dirk Nowitzki, you got to realize they're playing you one-on-one right now with Joel Anthony. With all due respect, make a play. Force them to double team, and then you become a playmaker. Up until the point they double team, you've got to take advantage of your matchup.
That torn tendon in the left middle finger again. Doesn't look like it's bothering him. Kidd is on Wade. Gets past him, and the finish! Wade throws it down. Heat back up by three.
The Mavericks have 2 7-footers on the floor. Where are they on those penetrations to the rim?
Stevenson, the penetration, kicks it out to Kidd. Open look. Chandler, offensive rebound, and he's fouled. And it's going to go against Wade.
Earth to Mavericks big men. When this guy back dribbles, where are you? I mean, this is 5-6 dribbles. And let's not let Jason Kidd off the hook. He has to do a better job of staying between him and the basket.
Stevenson catches knuckleball. Another offensive board for Chandler. Stripped and fouled. So Chandler will go to the line. Mavericks fighting back once again. That foul is on Joel Anthony, his second.
A great effort by Tyson Chandler. Draws a foul on one offensive rebound. They take it back out, and he creates another possession and gets him to the free throw line.
Chandler in his first year with Dallas, a terrific season for him. He was almost the perfect fit for this team. Finished third in the voting for Defensive Player of the Year. All defensive second team. First time he got that honor. And only the second Mav to ever be honored defensively like that. First one of your all-time favorites, Derek Harper. He had a regular season, career high in field goal percentage, free throw percentage. We talked about it. Dirk Nowitzki said he's the most positive teammate he's ever been around. His team down by two, though. Just over 5 minutes gone by here in the third. Bosch spins into the paint. Tough shot. Nowitzki, good strong rebound. Mavs now look to push. This is what Kidd said he wanted to do. And he traveled. Just dragged his pivot foot. You see the turnovers already 4. They had 8 in the entire first half, but 4. In 5.5 minutes here in the third. Pass inside to Bosch, blocked by Marion. There's that help defense in the paint. Nowitzki inside to Chandler, stolen by James. Timed it perfectly. And then James stops and gets hit from behind. And a technical foul on Rick Carlisle. First a personal, and now the one-shot technical. So they'll take one free throw and take it out of bounds. The foul's on Nowitzki, his second.
I don't understand the technical foul call. Again, it's the NBA Finals. I watch these two coaches. They have great decorum on the sideline. Dwayne Wade undressed one of them in the first half, and there was no technical foul. To me, it shouldn't be, there shouldn't be a double standard here. I mean, LeBron James gets away with, Nowitzki fouled him, LeBron James elbowed him, Rick Carlisle just said he elbowed him.
Now, you don't know what Carlisle said, but you were right on Wade. Wade, in the first half, threw a little tantrum.
Actually, I do know what Carlisle said because I watched his lips, and I'm a lip reader. He didn't curse.
No bad words?
None.
Wade up top to James, fakes the three. Bibby, it's good. Mike Bibby from downtown, his third three-pointer. And the veteran Bibby puts the Heat up by five.
You know, people don't realize how good that pass was from LeBron James. There's a guy next to him who he overlooks and hits Mike Bibby on point.
Meanwhile, a foul on Anthony. That's his third.
Just an underrated part of both of these guys' game, the ability to pass the basketball. So the skip pass, putting Mike Bibby in position to knock down the shot. I'm watching how good LeBron James is. It makes me think about what Scottie Pippen talked about, how he was better than Michael Jordan. I don't agree with that. Like Charles Barkley said, how did he jump over Kobe Bryant on the all-time list? And Scottie Pippen saying that is like my kid saying that Jeff Van Gundy is a better dad. I've been too good to you.
Yeah, but I didn't like that he ran away from his comments. You say it, stick with it. But you know what? I have even a bigger problem with something else. He's employed by the Chicago Bulls now, and he is absolutely trashing their players as Bosch hits a jump shot after the season. I mean, he goes after Carlos Boozer, goes after their guy. You're employed by the team. They had a heck of a year. They were beaten by a great team. What are you doing?
He's creating controversy, that's for sure. Marion, high pass to Terry. Good catch. Shot clock at six. Marion, the scoop layup. Pretty move. And Marion having a good offensive game. He's got 16 on 7 of 9 from the field.
This guy has battled all playoff long.
His first NBA Finals. He was in the conference finals with Phoenix. Bosch draws contact. And a foul is against Chandler. So Chandler now with three.
Good ball movement. Marion loves to go left. Blows by LeBron James, which is difficult to do. Nice little scoop, left-hand finish.
Marion had one of, as we've seen, Brian Cardinal is coming into the game. Rick Carlisle trying some different things. Cardinal's only played 7 minutes so far in this postseason. 7 minutes and four games. So he's going to come in. Nowitzki will sit down. Cardinal, 34 years old, in his 11th year in the league. He's played for six different teams. It's his first year in Dallas. Well, they nicknamed him the custodian because of how hard he worked, but he's also a guy that can hit three-pointers. 1 year he was third in the league in three-point percentage. That was back with Golden State.
A lot of trust Rick Carlisle has in the custodian to put him in game two of the NBA Finals.
Well, I also think it's a reaction to Stojakovic's ineffective play.
Stojakovic has struggled. Kidd turns it over again and then fouls LeBron James. A smart foul. That was going to be a dunk. The foul is on Kidd. Kidd with some turnovers here in this third period. Overall, the team, six turnovers, and there's still 4 minutes to play in the third.
You give credit to the Miami Heat defense for increasing the intensity, but you don't want to let this Dallas Mavericks offense off the hook. This is bad execution and careless basketball turning it over.
But they don't have a lot of weapons once Nowitzki goes out. Who's a primary scorer? Jason Terry.
Wade wanted the ball right back. Wade the penetration, kicks it out, Bibby from the corner, bang! Three-pointer Mike Bibby, he's finally found the range. And the Heat with their largest lead of the night.
I don't know how long, even though Nowitzki struggled, how long they can keep him out. They just don't have enough offense on the floor.
It's Terry, Kidd, Marion, Cardinal, and Chandler. Wade, and a blocking foul call on Cardinal. Mavericks don't like the call. Wade having a superb game, 25 points and 6 assists. He's 11 of 15 from the field. That's the 14th foul. They're saying it put him at the line. It didn't appear he was shooting there.
Rick Carlisle realizing that they're struggling in the offensive end goes right back to Dirk Nowitzki, ready to put him back in the ballgame.
Wade hits the free throw. Dallas not happy. Felt that that foul was on the floor. Nowitzki, as you see. Well, he was the finals MVP back in 2006.
Did you see where the commissioner said they, he's thinking it's gaining traction, that they're going to wait through the playoffs to vote for the MVP going forward?
Interesting. By the way, they had a negotiating session. The league and the Players Association is marrying to the basket. Anthony got a piece of it, and Bibby comes out with it. Bibby throws it ahead to Wade. Wade fouled and back to the line. Once again, defense led by Joel Anthony leading to offense. Now what a turnaround here in this third period that started actually into the second quarter.
Again, Joel Anthony has yet to score in this series. Tremendous block shot. The timing to initiate the transition opportunity. Wade starting to live at the free throw line.
I'm looking at that replay. Jamal McGlaw, Runas Ilgauskas. I mean, if that was LeBron James or Dwayne Wade making that block, mouths would be open, they'd be standing up. They are just sitting there like ho-hum.
Well, they've seen Joel Anthony do their work.
They know his work.
Every
right?
day.
That's a good point. That's a good point.
The big cat and the big Z.
Everybody's got a nickname. 10-point lead. Again, this game was tied at halftime. Dallas had a 9-point lead in the final minutes of the second quarter, so a 19-point turnaround as Nowitzki gives Dallas a much-needed bucket there.
He's got to be more aggressive offensively. Those are the type of plays that he's got to make. Right now, upset that no call was made, but he's got to be aggressive.
Timeout. Eric Spoelstra. Bibby looking for James. And a turnover. That's their first one here in the third quarter. Whereas Dallas has been piling them up six in the quarter. That's been the difference here in this period. Nowitzki blocked by Anthony. Nowitzki doubled. Pass deflected as well. Terry. On the drive, trying to draw some contact, and he does. It's like the Miami Heat, it's like they change gears, and you don't have an answer for them.
Well, the difference is they're not just double-teaming. They're double-teaming with high hands, not allowing Dirk Nowitzki a clear, you know, line of vision towards passing. He's got to do a better job of being strong and creating that angle and then getting rid of the basketball.
You know, you were on McGlaur and Ilgauskas for not reacting, but you didn't react to that block either. And if that was LeBron James, you would have said, not on my watch. But you don't even give Joel Anthony the trite cliche that he deserves.
Did you just do an impersonation of me?
I like the way he changed his voice.
Oh, he always goes an octave lower than I can go. But give him his respect.
You're right. I apologize, Joel Anthony.
Under 2 minutes remaining. An incredible turnaround once again. Dallas up by nine with just under 3 minutes remaining in the second. And as we wind down the third, James again. Nowitzki lost it out of bounds. Last touch by Haslam. Well, here in attendance at the American Airlines Arena, Steve Nash. And a couple of his former teammates. Of course, he played with Nowitzki. They were great friends. Played with Sean Marion in Phoenix. Jason Kidd lines it up. Played with Kidd in Phoenix as well.
Is he watching the game or is he just texting?
He's a big Twitter guy.
Now's the time to watch.
James, meanwhile, with four personal fouls. Off the turnover. Kidd comes right back. Dallas fighting back again. Kidd misses. Chandler on the follow. And it's right back to four.
This is a resilient Dallas Mavericks basketball team. Give them credit. They found a way to climb back into this game.
They've done it in the regular season. They've done it in the playoffs. As they're desperate for a win here on the road to try and tie this finals up at one apiece. Final minute, third quarter. They couldn't close out the second. Can they close out the third? Bibby, difficult shot. How about Mike Bibby tonight? 5 of 8 from the field. He's got 14. And for Bibby, that's his high in the postseason. Guy shooting 25% in the playoffs prior to tonight. Nowitzki knocks it down. Nowitzki's, as you see, 6 of 15 from the field. James, the drive! LeBron James does it again!
No help defense allows LeBron James a direct line drive to the cup. Poor job by the Mavs.
Shot clock turned off. Terry on the pull-up. And Jason Terry gets one to go. He's just 1 for 5. Final seconds. James trying to draw a foul. Miller lost it. And that will end the third quarter.
Welcome back to Miami with Eric Spoelstra. From the final 4 minutes of the first half into this period, what's different about your basketball team?
Well, we play with much more energy and a better disposition. But offensively, we didn't finish the way we wanted to. A little bit sloppy there and without a purpose.
Dirk Nowitzki with 15 points. How satisfied to this point are you with your defense?
You can't feel satisfied with him. He's a shot maker, arguably the best in the league at that. We've got to get up and into the airspace and rely on the help.
Thank you. Mike.
Well, Doris, they had it, forcing those 6 turnovers, and you forced turnovers. Miami Heat, that usually leads to easy buckets down the other end and some highlight buckets as well. Barea, Terry, Haywood, Marion, and Nowitzki. Terry on the drive, flips it up, won't go. Rebound Haslam. Bosch could help defense. Now Dallas, as Miller lines up and misses. Dallas during these playoffs, 4 of their 12 wins came when they were trailing after 3 quarters. They've shown that comeback ability all postseason. Barea gets inside. And Nowitzki in and out. That one halfway down.
I'm surprised with the way he shot the ball that they're in this game.
Just 6 of 16. And Haywood grabs Haslam. Haywood hurt himself. And Haywood going back to the locker room as we check in with Doris.
Well, that right hip pointer, as soon as he was at the other end, he looked at Coach Carlisle and asked for a sub, and obviously heading back to the locker room. Guys, I'll have more for you in a few minutes.
All right, Doris.
We want more now, Doris.
Wade finding Miller. Miller sets. And tipped out of bounds by Bosch. Mavericks ball. Dallas want to tie this series up. They do not want to go home. Down 0-2. All the years in the finals, rarely has a team in the finals come back from an 0-2 deficit. As Barea misses, it's only happened 3 times. Marion flips it back up and in. One of them, of course, was back in 06. As Terry, good hustle, deflects it out of bounds. And for Jeff Van Gundy, let's go to Doris again.
Well, Mr. Van Gundy, strained right hip flexor, doubtful to return. Hope that's fast enough for you, sir.
Sir and Mr. Van Gundy, you don't deserve that kind of respect.
Oh, wow. When we asked for Doris to deliver, what did she do? She delivers like Wade and LeBron James.
And not just delivered, she checked you in her deliverance. I mean, her tone was right on point. I like that, basically saying, shut up, Jeff.
I don't think it was that type of tone.
Bosch stripped, lost the ball, trying to fight for it, looks to save it, but Stevenson picks it up. With all the terrific things Miami has done since the end of the second quarter, their lead is only 2. Terry. Ball knocked out of bounds. Dallas with 13 to shoot. It's what you admire about this Mavericks team. They have been fun to watch all year. A team that started so well. Had one of the best records in the NBA. Turn of the new year. But then Butler got injured. Nowitzki got injured. They lost 6 in a row, which is the longest losing streak in the Mark Cuban era. But they kept fighting back. And have had this unbelievable playoff run to get here to the finals. Terry lost it. Chalmers ahead to Wade. Turnovers just killing the Mavericks.
And the reason why is because right now it's tough for the Miami Heat to score in half court situations. The only way they're scoring is pushing the ball off the turnover. You got to do a better job on both ends of the floor if you're the man.
Shot clock at 7. Jason Terry with a hand in his face. Side of the backboard. Chandler has to put it back up. It didn't reset. Barea throws it up. And a 24-second violation. If you're just tuning in, Dallas had a 9-point lead with just under 3 minutes remaining in the second quarter, playing some terrific basketball, bouncing back after the loss in game one. But the Heat finished on a 9-0 run to end the second and exploded out of the gate in the third. Mavericks fighting back, however. Chalmers to the basket. Timeout, Mavericks. For the Miami Heat, the fourth quarters they've owned them. Opponents are scoring 17.5 points in the fourth quarter in this streak. Boston one time had a 13-point fourth quarter and a 14-point. There's another turnover. Way the other way. Leans in and draws the foul. In the games against Chicago, the Bulls had a 10-point fourth quarter, scored 17 in another one, 18 in another. They have just taken over in the fourth quarter, led by their defense.
If I'm Rick Carlisle, I say to my guys, if we're going to turn the basketball over like this, we might as well give them the trophy right now. There's no way in the world you're going to beat this Heat team turning the basketball over. Unforced errors just cannot happen.
And they have to ask themselves, again, the Jason Terry-James matchup. Can we go to Jason Terry? If not, I think Deshaun Stevenson or Kidd's a better option.
Well, Kidd coming in right now. And Chandler will sit, so they're going to go small.
They're going to go super small. Three tinies and the Matrix and Nowitzki.
But you really can get away with it because there's no post score for the Miami Heat. So you're actually matching up to them properly.
Well, no, because if Marion stays on LeBron James, then who's guarding Haslam or Bosh?
Barea on the drive, left-handed, flips it up, won't go. James the rebound, his 7th board. Still plenty of time, but the momentum has shifted once again. Wade back to James. Strip gets it back, and he traveled.
You know, if you think about it, going back to when Chris Bosh, as Jason Kidd is the initial defender on him, when Chris Bosh was in Toronto, the best way to defend him was with smaller guys.
And Nowitzki fouled as Udonis Haslam picks up the foul. It's only the first team foul. That's up to Miami. We'll need to try and stay out of Dallas. Such a good free throw shooting team, would love to get in that penalty and get to the line. Nowitzki just 6 of 16 from the field. They have done a tremendous job defensively on him. Although he's missed some shots, he's been hitting all playoffs like that. That's wide open. Wade with a 31-point game and still 8 minutes to play. Chalmers for 3. Bosh on the follow. How many times have we seen that from the Heat? 8 straight points in the lead, back to 10, equaling the largest of the night. Nowitzki doubled. Turns it over. Wade fouled by Terry. We've seen James, we've seen Wade, and now Bosh with a thunderous follow.
And part of the problem with going small, you got to make sure you keep a body on guys. Nobody meets the body of Chris Bosh. Give him credit. Recognizing the mismatch, attacks the offensive boards, and a big-time putback.
And you're right. Like, that's Sean Marion. That's his responsibility. You can't watch the flight of the ball like he was doing. You got to hit first, then search the ball.
Largest lead of the night with 7:37 remaining. It's like Groundhog Day for the Miami Heat. These fourth quarters, turning it up defensively, forcing turnovers, getting out on the fast break. Ten straight points, and the lead is a dozen. Marion kicks it out. Barea open. In and out. Marion the rebound. Stripped, lost it again. Active hands. James to Chalmers. Wade the corner. That's good. Three-pointer from Dwayne Wade. And the Heat have blown this game open. A 13-0 run. And Miami in control with 7:14 remaining.
You know, Bosh has had two very rough shooting nights. And as Nowitzki's fouled. And again, it goes to the point, those three don't have to play well on the same night. They need two of the three.
And I totally disagree with the call and Rick Carlisle and Dirk Nowitzki and Mavs bench. This should be an act of shooting. Never put the ball back down and the foul was committed.
Seemed like a continuation. Nice pass again from Nowitzki. Marion misses the layup. Strip knocked out of bounds. And it's Dallas Ball with six to shoot.
Well, Joey Crawford makes the call. Here's the foul. Never puts it back down. Dirk Nowitzki should have been at the line shooting too.
Absolutely. Chandler back in the game. Can't get it to go. Wade the rebound. 13 straight points right now for the Heat. And Dallas shooting 1 of 11 from the field here on the fourth with 5 turnovers. Wade for 3. Nowitzki. 4 Heat players around him. Terry's wide open and gets it to go. Terry now 3 of 9 from the field.
Now remember their great comeback against Oklahoma City. Unfortunately, they're playing against a better team. But they have the ability to put on a big spurt if their 3-ball gets going.
That was the game they were down 15 with just under 5 remaining. Forced the overtime and then won in overtime. Kidd throws it ahead to Terry. And Terry a layup. So a couple of quick buckets as Eric Spoelstra calling a quick timeout as the lead cut to 11. And still 5:45 remaining. We've seen it from the Mavericks all season. Never giving up. His 13 field goals tonight. 10 of them have come in the paint. His attacking style, and again, so many of them off those turnovers, that has been the story. As Dallas turning it over. James, he thought he got hit in the rim, stopping the ball as Kidd throws it ahead to Marion. Terry. Foul by Chalmers, so Dallas will go to the line with 5:21 remaining.
And you know the play we just saw with LeBron James? He didn't really do that a lot in Cleveland. Come off screens. He never felt comfortable. I like it. They've run that a few times tonight. Catch and go. And give him some opportunities to penetrate off the ball versus having the ball where the defense is staring at him. Good screen by Bosh. Freeze of the defense and he just misses a point blank layup. But I like the strategy.
He's got to work on his ability to finish.
Terry hits a pair. So Terry has scored 6 straight. 14 now for Terry. They've got it back down to single digits. A 9-point game. And Dallas with their much improved defense, that's what they need now. Stops. This was a 2-point game earlier in the fourth. It ballooned to 15. Bosch knocked away by Kidd. And it's still Miami ball. They've got five to shoot. Eric Spoelstra calling out a play from the sideline. Chalmers on the drive. Back to Bosch with one on the clock. Here comes Dallas again. Ball deflected. Game one was close down the stretch. It was a 4-point game with under four remaining. And again, the Heat turned it up defensively. Mavericks trying to make a comeback again. Shot clock at 8. Nowitzki against Bosch, spinning. Marion the drive, flips it up, banks it in. Difficult shot for Marion, and it's a 7-point game. 8 straight points now. The crowd's got a little quiet here.
And now it boils down to, can you get stops? Can you continue to get enough stops to allow your offense to get back into this game?
An 8-0 run in 2 minutes. James goes right at Chandler and draws the foul. Chandler not happy with the call. And James will go to line for only the third and fourth time tonight. 5 on Chandler.
Well, again, good defense initially by Bosch. But give Marion credit, attacking the closeout. And I thought down here Tyson Chandler did a good job going straight up, avoiding the foul, but he got called for it.
James has missed both of his free throws tonight. Again, now he's only taken, this will only be his 5th free throw in the 2 games. Hard to tell with that. Now we'll get a better angle here. Perhaps. It's both free throws. 20 for James. 9-point game as we get to 4 minutes remaining. Nowitzki back up to Kidd, wide open for 3. Knocks it down. Jason Kidd, a clutch shot, and it's a 6-point game.
And again, the playmaking ability of Dirk Nowitzki forced the double team on the heads and then find a wide open teammate.
Boy, you've got to love the Mavericks fighting back again here on the road. It was a 15-point lead for Miami just a few minutes ago. Good ball denial from Terry. James falling away. Difficult shot. That misses. Nowitzki the rebound. Here come the Mavericks. Under 3.5 remaining. Nowitzki is open. Now they quickly converge. Back out to Kidd. Terry the drive. Terry the pull-up. It's good. And a 4-point game. Timeout Miami. Jason Terry had 8 points through the first 3 quarters, has 8 points here in the fourth, and Dallas right back in it. It's a 4-point game after they trailed by 15. You love this Maverick veteran team, the way they've been able to battle back, guys. What's been the key, Mark?
Oh, really? They've taken care of the basketball the last couple of minutes and gotten quality looks on the offensive end. It's a matter of taking care of the ball.
All right, for the Heat now, Jeff.
Well, they can't get stagnant and rely on just one-on-one basketball. Got to keep the ball moving and try to create open shots. And right now, it's got to be Dwayne Wade to play pick and roll basketball.
Wade looking, finding James inside the Bosch. Chandler right up on him. Bosch on the drive, lost it out of bounds. Dallas ball. What a turnaround here in the fourth quarter. It looked like Miami had blown the game open. Well, the Mavericks fighting back. Nowitzki puts it up. Puts it in. 2-point game with 2:43 remaining. A 15-2 run.
And I like the set they've run the last 2 times. A staggered pick and roll for Jason Terry. More traffic, more difficult rotation to Nowitzki.
Haslam misfires. Barry in the rebound. Mavericks with a chance to tie or take the lead.
Going with the same exact set.
Kid almost lost it. Terry looking. Shot clock down to 8. Nowitzki off the dribble. Leans in. Shot blocked by James. Picked up by Kidd. He has to put it up. Alley-oop to Chandler. Knocked loose, and Haslam comes up with a loose ball. Heads-up play from Kidd as the shot clock was winding down, but they come away empty. Crowd gets on its feet in a 2-point game with under 2 to play. James with 3 on the shot clock. James fires up a 3. Rebound tipped out in the new 24. Wade with a big play. Bosh. Great ball denial from Kidd. Chalmers spinning. Haslam up top. 3 to shoot. James another 3. Won't go. Haslam the offensive rebound. Tried to save it. Ball still loose. Picked up by Terry. A minute remaining. Here goes Marion. Back to Nowitzki. Lefty layup. Banks it in and the game is tied. What a comeback from the Mavericks. Timeout Miami. A 17-2 run. And this crowd is stunned. An amazing comeback here in game 2 of the NBA Finals with 57.6 seconds remaining. Dallas down by 15 with 6:20 remaining. Forcing yet another turnover, and this bucket would tie the game. And the fans back in Dallas watching at the American Airlines Center erupting. Of course, remember back in 2006 when these two teams met in the finals, game 3, it was the Heat down by 13 with just over 6 minutes remaining. They came back, won the game, and turned the finals around. Dallas trying to do the same thing with this 17-2 run, but can they finish it off?
What is Jason Terry doing?
Well, he's backing off. Marion will guard James. Wade, shot clock at 8. Wade steps back a 3. Off the mark. Nowitzki the rebound. Hands it off to Kidd.
And Miami's gotten very poor shots down the stretch tonight.
Terry to Nowitzki. Puts up the 3. Puts it in. Dallas goes up by 3 with 26.7 remaining. A 20-2 run. One of the most incredible comebacks in NBA Finals history. Down 15 with 6:20 remaining, and now in the lead.
Well, I love the set they're playing out of in transition. Staggered pick and roll. Chandler then pins for Nowitzki, a wide open three-pointer for the best shooter going right now. This is beautiful basketball.
And Miami with that timeout, now out of timeouts. As Nowitzki, who has not shot the ball well tonight, with a clutch bucket, a three-pointer, and Rick Carlisle has seen his team do it again. We mentioned the comeback against Oklahoma City when they were down by 15 with just under 5 minutes remaining. This down 15 with just over 6 minutes left, but it's still not over.
And Miami has downsized, playing Bosh at 5, bringing Mike Miller back in the game.
And the reason why is because now, defensively, there's a price to pay when one guy is roaming. You put Mike Miller on the floor, he's a shooter. Now you have another threat.
Can they finish off this extraordinary comeback? Chalmers wide open. Oh! Chalmers knocks down the 3 and ties the game.
Jason Terry roaming on the inbound pass to try to prevent the inbound pass to go to Wade. And what a find by LeBron James. Jason Terry just hanging out.
How about Chalmers? Remember him back at Kansas, hit that big shot in the NCAA title game, the huge 3. And this one here ties it up with 24.5 remaining. Big shot after big shot here as we wind down the stretch here of game two. And now Dallas is out of timeouts. Miami, however, has a foul to give. What a remarkable finish here to game two. And we might still have a lot of time remaining if this one goes to OT.
Great, great finish. But I am absolutely stunned at the defense that Jason Terry just played. There is no excuse for helping in that situation. Your job is to stay connected. He falls asleep. And then Mario Chalmers all by himself. And what coach talked about, look at the pass by LeBron James. Immediately, instead of waiting for Wade, recognizing that Terry is cheating the play, this is a shoot-around jump shot. That's a practice jump shot. And Mario Chalmers knocks it down.
All right, so for Dallas, 24.5 remaining. So obviously 5/10 of a second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. How far down do they go to make sure that it's the final shot attempt, but at the same time, if they miss, get a chance for an offensive rebound?
Well, you don't have to worry as much about shooting like right at the buzzer because Miami has no timeouts left to advance it. But, you know, you have to take it down to four or under. Certainly. You don't want to give James or Wade the chance to push it.
And if I'm the Mavs, I'm running the same exact play, but I'm not putting the ball in Jason Terry's hands until I'm ready to attack. But the same double screen and roll, they're getting quality offense out of it.
Chalmers on Kidd. Terry, Nowitzki, Chandler, and Marion out there for Dallas.
They put Bosch on Nowitzki on this possession.
Seven to shoot. Nowitzki drives with underneath lefty layup, banks it in with 3.6 remaining. Miami out of timeouts, trailing by two. James back to Wade. Wade puts it up for the win. Off the mark, and Dallas has tied the finals with one of the most incredible comebacks in NBA Finals history. Dirk Nowitzki, the last 9 points for the Mavericks. And this building has gone quiet. The Mavericks do it again.
What a great game. And I love down the stretch. They put the ball in their best player's hands. And Dirk Nowitzki did not settle for a jump shot. Put the ball on the floor. And I guess we can say that that left finger is okay. Finishes with a big time lay-in. And then getting back, stopping the basketball, and contesting the shot of Dwayne Wade. Stellar job of sealing the deal by the Mavs.
And again, putting Bosch on him, who had done a good job, I think the Heat were late to help here.
They also, they had a foul to give, too.
I mean, that's just too easy. And, Mikey, that foul to give is very interesting because you would have had to take it earlier versus when he bounces it starting to go to the rim.
Nowitzki, the last 9 Maverick points. He's with Doris.
Dirk, you trailed by 15 points with 6 minutes and 20 seconds to go, and all the momentum was with Miami Heat. How did you guys turn this thing around?
Well, I thought defensively we really got up. We got into them. We pressured them full court. And then we scrambled defensively. And we even gave up some offensive rebounds, but we kept scrambling offensively. When we get stops, we can move and we can play off the flow. I think they're really doing a great job on our set offense, and we didn't really have much going. So I thought that the stops and the runouts really made the game easier for us.
When Chalmers made the three, you were visibly frustrated going to the bench. Take us through the last play and your ability to respond after that disappointment.
Well, you know, to get the lead after being down 15 was big, and then we just leave a shooter wide open. So it was a mental breakdown. But, you know, we still had a good position. We're at 24 seconds. We had the ball. It's a tie game. And they actually had a foul to give. So I think I went a little earlier thinking it might foul, and then we have to take it out of bounds. But I was able to get by Bosch and make a layup. That was big.
Jason Terry broke out of the shooting slump, so I guess we'll forgive him for that that last play. How important was it to see him make shots tonight for you guys?
Well, I think they're really doing a good job. And like I said, they run him off the line. They run all our shooters off the line. They're very athletic on the perimeter. So finally there in the fourth quarter, we found some opening. They really sucked in off our penetration. And finally, he got some open looks. He got a run-out layup, and that was big in the fourth. We definitely needed some scoring there.
Dirk. Thank you.
Thanks, Dirk.
A 22-5 run in the last 6:20. And Dallas with an unbelievable victory here in Miami to snap the home winning streak. First home loss of the playoffs for the Heat. The Dallas Mavericks even up the 2011 NBA Finals at one game apiece. He scores the bucket here in Miami. The Maverick fans back in Dallas at the American Airlines Center erupt. And they will welcome home their team in Game 3 on Sunday with open arms.